Very good morning, children. I'm Ramya here. So yes, how are you all? Fine, no? Good. Yes. So this is the continuity of the second lesson, right? So part two of the second lesson, the land of the little man, right? Yeah. Yes. So let's have a recap of the previous class. What did we see in the previous class? Do you remember anything? I said to go through the lesson. Did you gone through the lesson? Yeah. What did we see? Can you recall it? So Gulliver, he was an Irish surgeon and sailor. I said no, he was a doctor. What is it? Surgeon, which means doctor, and sailor who travels in the water. Ship. Who travels in the ship, right? Yeah. So what happened during one of his voyages? Voyages in the sense, I have said in the new words now, voyages, which means journey. Journeys by ship. So during his voyages, one day, due to strong wind, storm, which means storm, ship sinks in the water. So he manages, he swims and he lands over the seashore. He safely lands over the seashore and he had on the soft grass, okay, and he had a good sleep, slept peacefully. That's what I said, the word slept soundly, which means slept peacefully. So he slept peacefully. Then when he woke up, he was not able to wake up because his arms, which means hands, legs, hair, were tied to the ground. So suddenly he had a great feel that something is moving along his left leg and on his chest also. So when he looked down, he could see many men, many small little men who were just even 6 inches, not even more than 6 inches. So they were having bow and arrows in their hand, right? Yes. Then what did we see? So he was very surprised to see them, and he shouted loudly and he tried to tear the rope, which means rope, tear the ropes with great force. So due to by this action, this reaction of Gulliver, the little man, they frightened and they ran away. But after some times, they stood and they started to bow the arrows from a distance. So what happened by the bowing of arrows? It prickled Gulliver like needles, I said, right? Prickled in the sense sudden pain, okay? So till this we saw last class now. Yeah, in the last class we saw this. So let us see further. Shall we go ahead? Yes. Which means, shall we continue? Let us continue. Come. Are you clear? Good. So, read in your home so that you can be clear, or else you may have doubt, or else you may not have a clear idea. So, have a reading practice in your home. Try to read it. If you read it, you can understand more, okay? Yes. So when they started to bow the arrows, what Gulliver did, let us see. Gulliver acted wisely. So he acted wisely. So what wisely in the sense knowledgeable. See, I have given you your meaning. Wisely in the sense knowledgeable. So Gulliver acted wisely. He did not try to catch any of the little men. What wiseness in the sense? He didn't try to catch any of the little men. Instead, he made a sign to them and they stopped shooting arrows at them. So he just made a sign. Gesture. We used to say gesture, no? Shaking our legs, shaking our hands. or shaking our head. So he did some action like this, gesture, sign. Okay, then he brought the fingers of his right hand to his mouth to show that he wanted food. So what gesture in the sense? He just brought his right hand to his mouth to show that he wanted food. So he didn't disturb that little man. He didn't hurt that little man. He didn't catch. He didn't try to catch them. He just expressed that he feeling hungry. He wanted food. Right? The little man understood and soon bought several baskets of food and 2 barrels of wine. My God. I'll show you picture, you can understand. Just a minute. The food consisted of legs of mutton and loaves of bread. The men put their longest ladders against Gulliver's sides and carried the basket of food. See, seeing this, you can understand, seeing the picture. See. So what happened? They bought food, okay, basket of food. See here, can you see the basket of food and barrels of wine? See, this is called barrels, this is called baskets, correct? Baskets of food and barrels of wines, baskets. See here, okay. And what they did, see, this is the longest ladder they have put side, no, this is called the side of Gulliver. He laid here and this is the side of Gulliver. They put in the side of the Gulliver and see here, they have given the food. They are providing the food. What was the food? Wines, barrels of wines and legs of mutton. Mutton is there, no, so non-veg, legs of muttons, okay, and even loaves of bread, pieces of bread, that is called as loaves of bread. So they offered Gulliver food, right? Yes, so let us see the next. Carried the basket of food to his mouth. See, to his mouth, they carried the food to his mouth. Gulliver chewed and swallowed 2 or 3 legs of muttons and 3 of the tiny loaves at a time. What happened? He chewed and swallowed 2 or 3 pieces of mutton. He swallowed and chewed. Chewed and swallowed. And 3 of the tiny loaves at a time. He's a giant person. No, he's a big person. Giant person. So, small piece. The bread was small pieces. That's what tiny in the sense. Small pieces. So, at a time itself. At a time, 3 pieces of loaves were he ate. Okay, he ate 3 pieces of loaves. After he had emptied the baskets, the little man rolled the barrels of wine over his chin and opened the tops. See what happened. So after the food, what they did here, now in the chin, they kept the barrel. They rolled the barrel, okay, rolling in the sense like this, rolling, rotating, okay, rolling. So they rolled the wine on his chin and they opened the cap of the wine and they gave wine to Gulliver. Yes, barrels of wine over his chin and opened the tops. He emptied each barrel in one gulp. So what is the meaning of gulp? To swallow large amount of food or drink. Just to swallow large amount of food or drink in certain time. Okay, in certain time is called as gulp, right? So elders used to have gulp, in a gulp. So in certain time they can swallow, that is called gulp. And wanted more, so he swallow, so he he emptied each barrels in one gulp itself. He emptied everything, then he wanted more, but they had no more to give him. So sad, everything was got over because this is a giant man. No, he was a He was a large man, big man, big man. So it was not enough for him. He wanted more. Gulliver felt better now, but even though he felt better, the king and queen of these little people lived in the capital, about half a mile from where Gulliver was. The king ordered his men to bring the Man Mountain. See, they calling Gulliver as Man Mountain to him. It was not an easy thing to do, but the little men were very clever. They made a long carriage which was 3 inches high and had 22 wheels. See, 900 of the longest men along them rolled Gulliver onto it and fastened him safely. 1500 of the king's finest horses pulled the carriage along the road. Wow, very nice. See here, very interesting. What happened? So the king and queen, no, the little people, the little men of the king and queen, they lived in the capital. So where the capital was? About half a mile where Gulliver was. It was half a mile away from where the Gulliver was. So see, 1 mile equal to 5,280 feet is called 1 mile. So in that half a mile distance was there, okay. So what happened? The king ordered the men to bring the Man Mountain. See, you know mountain, how large it is, how big it is. So mountain. So here they compared Gulliver with the mountain. See how clever they have said Man Mountain. Right? The king ordered to bring the Man Mountain, to bring Gulliver to him. But it was not an easy thing, right? Because he was so big, so large, so tall, no? So how they will bring him? See, for that also they did one trick. They used one trick. But the little man were very clever. Very clever in the sense, very intelligent. So what did they do? They made a long carriage which was 3 inches high and 22 wheels were there. 3 inches high, 22 wheels were there. And even 900 of the strongest men along them rolled Gulliver onto it and fastened him safely. So what happened? So big, the carriage was so big, long, big, long, it was long, long. So it was very long, they made that, and it was 3 inches high and 22 wheels were there, okay. So 900 long, strongest men, 900. Strongest man rolled Gulliver onto it in the sense upon the carriage very safely they have made, and fastly they have rolled Gulliver on that carriage, okay. And see, 1500 of the king's finest horses, no, king's horses, finest in the sense good horses pulled the carriage along the road. Seeing this picture, you can understand very clearly. See, large, long it is, carriage, right? See here, wheels, 22 wheels they have said. See the horses, right? So the tiny people, they are also walking along with Gulliver. Can you understand this? So 1500 horses, right? Yes. Can you understand by seeing this picture? Good. So let's see what happened after reaching that place, right? The next day Gulliver was brought to the capital. Okay, so the next day only they brought Gulliver to the capital. They untied his hands and legs and allowed him to stand up, because now they knew that he didn't intend to harm them. Okay, but they but they chained in the sense tied with the chain, okay, but they chained his left foot to the carriage with 90 tiny chains, said no, tie with chains to prevent him from escaping. So what happened? Next day they brought Gulliver to the capital, okay, and they untied in the sense they removed Gulliver's hand and leg and they allowed him to stand up. Why did they do this? Why did they allow him to stand up? Because they know that now he won't intent. What is the meaning of intent? I have said in the new words now, the meaning of intent is to want or to plan to do something. Okay, so they know that he won't plan or he don't wanted to hurt them. Okay, he won't plan or he don't wanted to hurt them. Who? Gulliver. So he won't hurt them. Gulliver won't hurt the little men. The men came to conclusion, right? See, they won't harm. He won't harm. Gulliver won't harm the little man. But what happened? They chained his left foot to the carriage with 90 tiny chains. See, 90 tiny chains. So why did they do that? To prevent in the sense I have said in new words. What's the meaning of prevent? So just by heart the new words first. Okay. Prevent in the sense stop. So why did they tie his left foot? To stop him from escaping. He should not escape. No. For that purpose they have tied his left foot. Right. The king, the queen and thousands of little men, women and children came to see the man mountain, right? Very good. Wow, nice. So what happened? The king, the queen and the thousands of little men and even women, children, everyone from that village, they all came to see this Gulliver, the man mountain, right? Yeah. Most of these people were friendly to Gulliver. So what happened? They were very friendly. They liked Gulliver. But some of them were hostile. Some of the people were hostile and started shooting arrows at him. What happened? What is the meaning of hostile? I have said in new words. No, hostile in the sense. Can you answer for this? Very unfriendly, right? So some of the people were unfriendly to Gulliver and they what did they do? They started shooting arrows at him. Gulliver stitched. Out his hand. For just a minute. Where it is? Gulliver stretched out of his, how to say the meaning of stretch. Yes, if you are writing for a long hour and your hands are paining, what will you do? You will stretch your hands now. Yeah, that is called a stretched. What it is? Stretched. So Gulliver stretched out of his hands and even when you get up from the sleep, what will you do? You will stretch your arms, no? You will stretch your hands. That is called a stretch. Okay, so Gulliver stretched his hand. And caught six of the men. Caught in the sense, past tense of catch. Okay, and he caught six of the men. He caught the six of the men. He put five of them into his pocket. Six he caught, no? So five he put into his pocket and pretended to eat the sixth one. So pretended, since just he acted that he's going to eat the sixth one. The men started crying. So what happened? The men know they. He started to cry. Gulliver let them go. So what happened? Finally, already I have said no. So he didn't have an intent to arm the people. He didn't have a plan to arm the people. So he just left the sixth man and even the five man, six people, six little men he caught. No, the six also he left. Gulliver lived happily on this island for many months. Okay, so what happened? For many months, Gulliver lived happily on this island. The king appointed 300 cooks to prepare his food. Right, what happened? So finally, everyone liked Gulliver and he lived happily on that mountain for several months, for many months. And the king appointed 300 cooks to prepare his food for that mountain man, for that giant, for that large big man. King appointed 300 cooks to prepare his food and 300 tailors to make a new suit, in the sense new dress for him. Okay, 300 tailors also to make a new dress for him, and six of the wisest men taught him the language of the island. Already I've said, no, what is the meaning of wisest? Brilliant, knowledgeable men. Okay, knowledgeable men. This is the plural of the man is called as men, M-E-N, men. Plural of man is called as men. Six of the wisest men taught him the language of the island. Got it? Clear? Yeah. From the wisest men, Gulliver, Gulliver learned that the little country was called Lilliput. Okay, Lilliput. So what it is, the little country is called as Lilliput. What is the little country called as Lilliput? So here it is, Lilliput. Okay, so this is adapted from Gulliver's Travel. Adapted in the sense, this is taken from Gulliver's Travel. Jonathan Swift, right? Got it? So here our lesson ends. Good. It was very interesting, no? Yeah. Superb. So just go through the lesson. Okay. Read the lesson. Have reading practice at your home. Okay, ma. Thank you. Bye-bye.